Welcome to my channel, All for Health with Jane. Family, we are still on the Senzo Meyiwa murder trial. On this video, we are going to watch and listen to Advocate Baloyi as he is taking Colonel Steyn through his re-examination of his evidence in chief. Colonel Steyn stands firm. He doesn't change. He's not movable by anything that was said by the defense, as we see him still saying the same things that he said before in his evidence in chief. Family, let's watch and listen.
Adjournment. The face of Colonel Steyn was shown live on TV. This is a contravention of the conditions that the court has laid down, that no witness face might be flighted.
So what was the reason?
They say it was a mistake. We reserve our opinion as far as that is concerned, but we've been given the assurance that the footage will be deleted and will not be shown under any circumstances. That will be the only condition.
Who is saying that? Who is the person in charge of this?
The court reporter was here, and the issue was raised with him.
Colonel, I see the freedom.
No, it's fine, man.
I'm taking the service a little faster.
That's fine. No,
it's okay.
Yes, thanks.
Yeah, because they're not supposed to do it.
I understand them.
Yeah.
Not a problem, thanks.
They can take out Dricker's stain.
Yes. they say the witness turned around.
And then?
And faced the camera, and that is the reason why they say his footage was captured.
Okay.
We will only let it slide on condition that it doesn't happen again, my lord.
Thanks, yeah. I apologize for that.
Yes, thank you. Colonel Steyn, we are on page 46 of your affidavit. The conversation between Longwe and Zandi, and we referred you to the download of Longwe. The time that is reflected there, and we ask you to comment on the time that is reflected there and page 46 of JJJ1, the section 205
that's
of Ms. Kelly Kumalo.
No, that's correct, my lord. If you compare that time on the Vodacom spreadsheet, it's 18:57. And if you go to the download, it shows 04:57 p.m. And if you add the two-hour rule, it's exactly in the same time.
And with reference to exhibit triple K 4, the first page thereof, Advocate Nsholelo put it to you that there in the shaded portion, there appears page 23.
That's correct, my lord.
And she also referred you to the 15th of October 2014, the third last page on the same exhibit. There appears an entry P4411, page 4411.
That's correct, my lord.
And she put it to that is an indication that you are fabricating.
Yeah, that is definitely not true.
Yes.
Like I mentioned, I did it in the presence of, during my consultation with Advocate Meloy and Tupanda.
Lana Glama, Peppermint Billige, U Lago Palo Conagla, Namala, every Combisa Conaga, Advocate Msholo, Ugutigna, the P23, Opali, well, appear, Besseguano, P4411, Washo, Ugutige, Ufaga, Zilobia Nage, Opfagel, Namayindo, Oyen Zileg, Nanjama Besseng Shila Gutaglon, Coniso, Futulo, Mago and Zage, Ukonagi, Advocate Ganyanayo, Advocate Sibanda.
And these entries, what do they refer to? What is the purpose of those entries?
The entry on the first page, the 20 page 23, that is my statement, my exhibit 01.
U 23, normal P 23, opali well, anage, the statement sum exhibit 01.
And the page 4411, that actually refers to the page on the Vodacom records, the section 205.
Besaguti ge UP 4411 ge ushoge ngama record agwa Vodacom is section 205.
And when were these entries made?
On the morning during our consultation.
Well, logo kwenziwa ge kusekuseni nkathi ke ngangikhuluma ke na nabeshushisi.
Yes. Right. Is it during the current session or the previous session?
No, this session.
Yes, we're
referring to not the August.
No, not
proceedings.
To the August.
This year's proceedings.
That's correct.
Yes. And in the same vein, Advocate Nisi suggested that we've already partly covered this, that the reason why the times don't follow on each other on exhibit K4 is because the information, as he put it, was planted.
That's also not true. It's definitely not planted. That is not the only entry which is not in a numeric order. If you go through the rest of the paper, there's other dates which also not 100% correct.
Besashiloge, bonawo bese khulumele ke lokho ukuthi ke ushilo ke advocate minister ukuthi ke imbangela ke ukuthi laphayana ke lama entry laphayana noma lokho kubhaliwe laphayana kungahambi ngokulandelelana ke ngoba into nje efakiweke noma ebekiwe noma ke eplantiweke uma singasho ke cha akusona ke iqiniso lokho akusiyona phela ke into engahambi ngokulandelelana ekhona laphayana.
He also added that the fact that there was deletion of certain information might also have had an influence or an impact.
That's correct, my lord. If you go to the contact list, you see clearly that there was some stuff deleted.
Ngishiloke nokuthi ke ngenxa yokuthi ke khona ke izinto ezasulwa ke lokho ke kwakungaba nomthelela ke uma uya kuona ke ama contact list uyabona ukuthi khona ke okwasulwa laphana kungaba nomthelela.
And just lastly, on the issue of the evidence being planted, you responded that you receive the CD from the investigating team and that the XRY program cannot be manipulated. You confirm that?
That's correct, my lord.
And Shiloh Ngutige is sitting, I told her, Timba Elpenyayo, Ngutige, the business Ngutige XR, Ngutige Aguko, Ongagwenza, Ulona.
Advocate Msololo put it to you that without seeing the device itself, the downloads cannot be confirmed. Can one access the downloads without the XRY program?
No.
Awazi ke ukuthi ke ama downloads ungawathola ke ngaphandle kwayo ke le program noma lo lahlelo olubizwa ngokuthi ke XRY.
Thank you, my lord. That is all.
Family, we have heard that in this re-examination, Colonel Steyn is still emphasizing on his two-hour rule. And another thing, he still maintains that he hasn't fabricated any evidence. He maintains that whatever he is given, it's exactly what he found when he was analyzing this data. Would he tell this court if he fabricated this information? Would he agree that he did that? He did, you know, fabricate this information. He did cook this information as Advocate Mgomezulu puts it. Would he agree to this court family? You know, sometimes when people say things, they think other people do not have the mind to think for themselves. It's obvious. If he fabricated, he was never going to tell this court. Anyway, thank you so much, family, for watching this video to the end. Please do not forget to like this video before you leave. Subscribe for my channel if you haven't done so yet. I love you, family. Thank you. Bye.